Hello and welcome to Fieldwire. Nested locations can be associated with tasks in order to tie specific work to exact locations on site. With the location task attribute, your team can easily identify and report progress of work in specific areas. In this video, we will cover how project admins can create and manage locations on a project. To learn more about adding locations to tasks, check out our video on creating and responding to a task. Please note, only project admins can manage locations on a project. From the web app, open the project settings by clicking on the gear wheel in the lower left-hand corner of your project toolbar. When you click on Manage Locations, you'll have two options to bulk import existing or create new locations one by one. Let's start with creating locations one by one. If you only have a few locations and are starting a brand new project, this is a great option for you. You can create nested locations from within a task on web or mobile or within the settings page. In this video, we are showing you how to create them on the web application. To see how you can create new locations from a task on a mobile device, check out our other video on assigning locations to tasks. Click the New Tier 1 Location button in the pop-up that appears. Then enter the name of the Tier 1 location you'd like to add and click Create. We recommend adding the child locations under your first Tier 1 location before moving on to adding another Tier 1 location. To add a child location to your Tier 1, simply click the plus button on the right-hand side. Let's add a nested location under the East Area location. You'll click on the plus icon to the right of the East Area location name, enter in the desired name of the location, and click Save. If you want to add another location under your Tier 2 location, you're able to follow the same process. Fieldwire supports up to 5 layers of location nesting. Now let's walk through how to bulk import existing locations with a CSV file. This is the recommended option for customers with hundreds or thousands of locations, like a large mega project or a complex residential job. Let's start by once again going to your settings page, scrolling down to tasks, and selecting Manage Locations. Click the Import button and there is a link to an instructions file on how to set up your CSV file to successfully import your locations. Fieldwire also provides a link to an empty template to help you get started. Select the link to the instructions first. There are two tabs in this file. One shows you the instructions of how to format your CSV, and the other is an example of location breakdowns. These will help you correctly import your locations without having to go back and address errors. The most important things to remember are to keep the column headers, tiers, 1 to 5. Do not edit or make any changes to the template, and enter all locations starting in the cell labeled A2. You can click on the other tab called Sample Data to see an example. Note that each location has its full path associated with it. If there are blank tiers, then you will receive an error. You can click on our Help Center article to discover ways to troubleshoot and fix those errors. Once you've identified and fixed those errors in your file, re-upload the corrected CSV. Now that you know how to format your CSV file, go back to the original pop-up in Fieldwire and click on the Empty Template link. From there, you can easily enter all your locations in the prescribed format. Depending on your project, you may have only 2 or 3 tiers of locations that are important for you to track. It could be by building, floor, zones, or even phases of a project. Once you decide what your tiers will be, add all the Tier 1 locations and their subsequent tiers. For instance, if your project has multiple buildings across a large campus, you can add each campus by area. Then building 1, floor 1, then drag floor 1 down to add additional rooms to that floor. Then add your other Tier 1 and Tier 2 locations. Once you added all your locations, upload your CSV file to see all your updated locations in the pop-up. You can edit the name of a location with the pencil icon, or delete the location altogether with the trash bin icon. Deleting a location has a couple implications. First, everyone on the project will lose access to that location. Second, any child locations or locations that were nested under this deleted location will also be deleted. Lastly, deleting a location means you'll also be deleting the defined location in tasks. This means those tasks will no longer have a location tied to them. You can search for a location with this search bar. When you type in the location name you're looking for, Fieldwire shows you the name you searched for in bold. We'll also show you the different levels of locations, from Tier 1 to the child locations, and where the location you're searching fits into that structure. This makes it easy for you to pinpoint the exact location you're looking for. For more detailed information on creating and managing nested locations, please check out our help article linked in the description box. If you have any questions, please contact us at support@fieldwire.com.